It's time to run power to the Calliope. This is a socket very similar to what's on your computer, where 110 volts comes into your computer. For the Calliope, same thing, power comes in, there'll be an on-off switch. When the power is turned on, it will give power to the electronics inside the Calliope and supply 110 volts to this outlet socket. From here, power goes to the blower, where it is regulated to 24 volts DC for the blower motor. When you're laying this out, it's a little bit easy for these things to get off, especially when you're dealing with grain and wood. And if you have a 3D printer, you start thinking about, how can I make my life easier? I drew this up on Fusion 360. That holds everything in perfect alignment. And I'm doing a test on this piece of wood. Lay that thing out, drew some lines around here, and I know where I want to put my holes for the screws, and I'm going to put a bigger hole here and here. Go to the router table, put this on here, see if I can use a pattern bit to cut out these outlines. The router bit I wanted to use wasn't quite long enough for this 3/4 inch pine. So I used the larger router bit. The larger router bit got into this corner pretty well. Did not clean up this corner. And a little bit short on these. So I went in with a file, flat and triangular, and cleaned up a little bit. Now these pieces go in quite firm. And this one has some pretty good size holes that go all the way through to the front. So after this is wired, I'll have to seal this with silicone because this is on the inside of the wind chest. Another option would be to go ahead and use the same plate and leave those on there. Mount that on the back of the Calliope like this. And that gives me a little more depth here for my silicone. With the Calliope completed, there's an on-off switch here. I printed up two different pieces to mount the switch. This one is a template for the rectangular shape of the switch. And that switch is in the wood. It's quite solid. And then the cover plate has a recess in here, and that switch nests in that recess again to stabilize the switch. I added on and off to the final version. On the right side of the Calliope, this is the plug that leads to the MIDI player, or the MIDI reader. And I printed a little part that goes into the wood, dresses it out a little bit. Looks better than just being on the bare wood. The STL file for the router template and mounting plates, the DIN pin socket mount, will be on Thingiverse.